morning, a very warm welcome to you on this the third Sunday of Easter, 26th of April. Hope you're all well. I've just come down to the church on my walk. You can see it still standing. Today we celebrate the appearance of our Lord at Emmaus. We remember the two disciples walking back from Jerusalem to their home. They are in despair because of the death of Jesus. Jesus joins them. They don't know it's him, but he joins them, explains the scriptures, and then he appears at the breaking of the bread. They are so pleased, they are so excited. They run at great speed back to Jerusalem to tell the disciples he truly is risen from the dead. Please see our pew sheet, which includes notice and information about the Zoom coffee morning on Tuesday. Also of a competition, a limerick competition, and a TikTok competition. Other notices will be broadcast at the end of this service. And now we begin with the opening words of our Eucharist. Christ is risen. He has risen indeed. Alleluia. The order of service for this Eucharist can be found on the All Saints website. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The light and peace of Jesus Christ be with you, and also with you. We come before God, remembering our wrongdoing, but also his forgiveness and mercy. Christ, our Passover lamb, has been sacrificed for us. Let us therefore rejoice by putting away all malice and evil and confessing our sins with a sincere and true heart. Jesus Christ, risen Master and triumphant Lord, we come to you in sorrow for our sins and confess to you our weakness and unbelief. We have lived by our own strength and not by the power of your resurrection. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. We have lived by the light of our own eyes as faithless and not believing. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. We have lived for this world alone and doubted our home in heaven. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. The Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And the collect for the third Sunday after Easter. Almighty Father, who in your great mercy gladden the disciples with the sight of the risen Lord. Give us such knowledge of his presence with us, that we may be strengthened and sustained by his risen life, and serve you continually in righteousness and truth. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And so we sing our first hymn.
A reading from Acts 2, starting at the 14th verse. Then Peter stood up with the 11 and raised his voice and addressed the entire crowd. Fellow Jews and all of you who live in Jerusalem, let me explain this to you. Please listen carefully to what I say. Let all of Israel be assured of this. God has made this Jesus, whom you crucified, both Lord and Messiah. When the people heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and the apostles, Brothers, what shall we do? Peter replied, Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. The promise is for you and for your children and for all who are far off, for all whom the Lord our God will call. With many other words he warned them, and he pleaded with them, Save yourselves from this corrupt generation. And those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 were added to their number that day. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The second reading is taken from the first letter of Peter. If you invoke as Father the one who judges all people impartially according to their deeds, live in reverent fear during the time of your exile. You know that you were ransomed from the futile ways inherited from your ancestors, not with perishable things like silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, like that of a lamb without defect or blemish. He was destined before the foundation of the world, but was revealed at the end of the ages for your sake. Through him you have come to trust in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are set on God. Now that you have purified your souls by your obedience to the truth, so that you have genuine mutual love, love one another deeply from the heart. You have been born anew, not of perishable, but of imperishable seed, through the living and enduring word of God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Please join us as we sing As We Are Gathered. Alleluia, alleluia. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live, and everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Alleluia. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Now on that same day, two of them were going to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem, and talking with each other about all these things that had happened. While they were talking and discussing, Jesus himself came near and went with them, but their eyes were kept from recognizing him. And he said to them, "What are you discussing with each other while you walk along?" They stood still, looking sad. Then one of them, whose name was Cleopas, answered him, "Are you the only stranger in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have taken place there in these days?" He asked them, "What things?" They replied, "The things about Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and leaders handed him over to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel. Yes, and besides all this, it's now the third day since these things took place. Moreover, some women of our group astounded us. They were at the tomb early this morning, and when they did not find his body there, they came back and told us that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they did not see him." Then he said to them, "Oh, how foolish you are, and how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have declared. Was it not necessary that the Messiah should suffer these things and then enter into his glory?" Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them things about himself in all the scriptures. As they came near the village to which they were going, he walked ahead as if he were going on, but they urged him strongly, saying, "Stay with us, because it's almost evening and the day is now nearly over." So he went in to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, and he vanished from their sight. They said to each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking to us on the road, while he was opening the scriptures to us?" That same hour they got up and returned to Jerusalem, and they found the 11 and their companions gathered together. They were saying, "The Lord has risen indeed, and he has appeared to Simon." Then they told what had happened on the road, and how he had been made known to them in the breaking of the bread. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
May I speak in the name of the living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Last week, the disciples were in lockdown for fear of the religious authorities. Today, we find Cleopas and his companion going out on a journey, and Peter boldly preaching the message of Jesus. Peter has certainly been on a journey, from the frightened disciple who betrayed Jesus to the bold apostle and eventual martyr for his faith. After the resurrection and the absence of the flesh and blood Jesus, it seems initially that the disciples saw no option but returning to their previous life and waiting to see what happened. Peter went back to fishing, and the two on the road to Emmaus were presumably returning home to resume the life as they had known it. We don't know who Cleopas was, and we never hear of him again. But might he be the same as the Clopas mentioned in John's Gospel, whose wife Mary was one of the women standing by the cross? And might his companion on the road to Emmaus be that same wife? In undertaking any journey, we need to have some sense of where we're going and the best way to get there. But the travellers were confronted by the unexpected in the person of the mysterious stranger who interprets to them the prophecies about Jesus in the scriptures. What was the disciples' problem? They knew the whole history of Jesus' life and ministry, and presumably were also thoroughly familiar with the Jewish scriptures and the references in Isaiah to the suffering servant and other references. Yet it seemed that they continued to need instruction in how to interpret them, and this is what the stranger provides. It's clear from this that the scriptures alone were not enough, and they could only make sense to the disciples after they had experienced the resurrection for themselves. That's true for all of us. We can only hear what we are ready to hear. We can be told things repeatedly, but they remain head knowledge and are not real until we have experienced them. No doubt that's why the disciples in Mark, particularly, are portrayed as unable to understand what Jesus was all about until after the resurrection. It's in the breaking of bread that the disciples' eyes are opened, and they are enabled to understand everything else. In this moment of recognition, something happens and transformation takes place. It's only after a significant moment like this that we are enabled to look back and see that other things also make sense. As someone has wisely remarked, we live our lives forward but understand them backwards. And that's likely to be true for us at the present time, when we may find it difficult to make sense of things or to see the way forward. During these weeks of lockdown, I've been revisiting some of my favourite poems and remembered the often quoted lines by T.S. Eliot. "We shall not cease from exploration, and the end of all our exploring will be to arrive where we started and know the place for the first time." And these seem to me to be very profound in the light of our current situation. The place might be the physical space we inhabit, and I'm certainly getting to know some of my neighbours better, as when the sun shines, we emerge outside our front doors to get a breath of fresh air, examine what's growing in the flower pots, and have conversations with one another from across the street. I'm also becoming very familiar with almost every blade of grass on the town moor on my daily walk. Or perhaps it's our place in the grand scheme of things, our common humanity, and the realisation that we are all interdependent and that our actions have consequences for others. One thing is certain, and that is that we'll continue to travel without knowing exactly where we're going, and that after these restrictions are lifted, the world will be a different place, and we'll be different, but we can be assured that God will be travelling with us as he has been in the past, whether we recognise him as himself or in the presence of a mysterious stranger or strangers. Amen.
Holy God, in these strange times of uncertainty, loneliness and anxiety, walk with us as individuals and as the Church of God on our road to Emmaus. Open our eyes, as you did with Jesus' companions, to the reality of truth of the resurrection and our hope in Christ. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for all who minister and preach the gospel, bringing a light to those in darkness and words of love to those in need of comfort. In this time of closed churches and congregations locked down in their home, thank you for the hard work of all who are using social media and the internet to keep us informed, inspired and comforted by online services, preaching and teaching. We thank you for the gift of your Son, our Saviour, who walks with us all on our life's journey. We pray for all who travel with us in our family, among our friends, and within this community. We pray for a deepening awareness of our need for one another and of your image in the hearts of everyone we meet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Jesus Christ, you travelled through towns and villages, curing every disease and illness. At your command, the sick were made well. Come to our aid now in the midst of the global spread of the coronavirus, that we may experience your healing love. Heal those who are sick. May they regain their strength and health through quality medical care. Heal us from our fear, which prevents nations from working together and neighbours from helping one another. Jesus, healer of all, stay by our side in this time of uncertainty and sorrow. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Compassionate God, be with the families of those who are sick or who have died. As they worry and grieve, defend them from illness and despair. May they know your protection and peace. We name in our hearts to you now all those we know in need of your presence this morning. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, throughout this coming week, we thank you for walking alongside us wherever our lives' paths lead. We pray that if, like those first disciples, we fail to be aware of you, forgive us for our human weakness and open our eyes to see you as a constant companion and friend. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
And so we have the peace. The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then they were glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you. Alleluia.
Be present, Lord Jesus Christ, our risen High Priest. Make yourself known in the breaking of bread.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Almighty and Eternal Father, and in these days of Easter, to celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of your wonderful works. For by the mystery of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell and restored in men and women the image of your glory. He has placed them once more in paradise and opened to them the gate of eternal life. And so, in the joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, while angels and archangels and the powers of all creation sing forever the hymn of your glory. Holy, 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 Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread and gave it to them and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Amen. So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice, made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes again. Jesus Christ is Lord. Lord, by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You are the Saviour of the world. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore let us keep the feast. Alleluia. Body of Christ. Blood of Christ. Body of Christ. Blood of Christ. Although we're not able to take the sacrament in our homes, we make our prayer to Christ, our living Lord, present with us at this very moment. And so we come to the post-communion prayer. Living God, your Son made himself known to his disciples in the breaking of bread. Open the eyes of our faith, that we may see him in all his redeeming work, who is alive and reigns now and forever. Amen. And so on page 13 in the order of service, together we pray. You have opened to us the scriptures, O Christ, and you have made yourself known in the breaking of the bread. Abide with us, we pray, that, blessed by your royal presence, we may walk with you all the days of our life, and at its end behold you in the glory of the eternal Trinity, one God for ever and ever. Amen. God the Father, by whose love Christ was raised from the dead, open to you who believe the gates of everlasting life. God the Son, who in bursting the grave has won a glorious victory, give you joy as you share the Easter faith. Amen. God the Holy Spirit, whom the risen Lord breathed into his disciples, empower you and fill you with Christ's peace. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Well, thank you for joining us today for this Eucharist. Very glad you could be with us. Do please look to the pew sheet where you'll find news and information about the coming week. I mentioned in the first video the Zoom coffee morning on Tuesday. Please see the details of how to be involved in that. You'll see a competition, a limerick competition to enter, with details also on the pew sheet. There is a opportunity to send in pictures of flowers from our gardens to be part of a page on our website. And please also notice the article about Christian aid. We cannot collect around our neighbourhood this year, but we can give generously and encourage our families and friends to give over the next few weeks during Christian Aid Week and beyond. So I look forward to seeing you next week. Bye bye.